Good Monday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick check of your forecast, which is going to be hot, humid, uncomfortable, and not great for outdoor activities as we go throughout the rest of the next couple of days, looking at some dangerously hot weather, in fact, across much of the area. So as the kids and the teachers and the principals and everybody else head back to school today, a lot of places still do not have school, but if you're heading back again, if you have outdoor activities like football, soccer, baseball practice, whatever you've got outdoors, marching band, a lot of places like that practicing for the rest of the year, and again, going to be steam heat out there and plenty of it across much of the Mid-South as we go into the rest of the day. So if you have plans for outdoors, please keep that in mind. Safety first. Even though it's just hot weather, it can be very toll-taking on you if you go out for too long. Coming up, we'll talk more about what it looks like when you push yourself too hard for hot weather and where you can get more information on that. If you can't stick around for the whole podcast, again, the forecast in the blue bar scrolling by here at the lower portion of your screen. And again, you can read about the chances of showers and thunderstorms there, or you can go to WREG.com/weather for more details on our 7 to 10 day forecast. Questions, concerns, anything you want to ask personally, again, you can send them directly to the email if you don't want to put them into the comments section right here. So once again, if you got any questions, just say so and bring more information on this forecast as we get in throughout the rest of the morning. Welcome to everybody who's checking in so far. Diana Tucker Hutcherson, very good advice, staying hydrated out there, very good idea. Stella Spray, falls about 41 days away. We'll take a look at that coming up here in just a little bit. Cindy Kins wouldn't have put it quite like that, but okay, to each his own on there. From Oxford, Mississippi, from the University of Mississippi, we've got, again, lots of sunlight, a little bit of patchy haze and fog around Lafayette County, and temperatures just below 80 degrees at this time with calm winds there. From Olive Branch, Mississippi, from former mayor, current meteorologist Sam Reichard, his Weather Underground weather camera, looking back to the northwest and seeing, again, mainly clear skies out there. Olive Branch Airport also checking in with a temperature of 79 degrees so far this morning, so pretty steamy into and around portions of northern Mississippi. Collierville on the square, some fog early this morning, and now again plain sunshine. Temperatures nearby at the Olive Branch Airport and also into around the area close to eastern Shelby County, back in the lower 80s already. Looking toward downtown Memphis, patchy haze and fog earlier this morning, but right now most of that is burning off, so sunshine galore across much of downtown Memphis as well. And from West Memphis, Arkansas, looking back toward the junction of I-40, I-55, everything moving along quite nicely at this time for travel here, at least. Corey Ventura will have updates on traffic. Already at 8 o'clock this morning, we've got a heat index at West Memphis at the airport of 95 degrees. So looking very steamy out there already so far across much of the area. Tracy Ashmore Coates, very good idea. Again, plenty of fresh water for the pets. And also shade or bring them inside to the air conditioning. Again, they're wearing the fur coats, you're not. So let's make certain that everybody out there, our fine four-legged friends, whatever species they happen to be for pets, let's make certain they're well all taken care of. Steve Kelly, good morning. Welcome to the show. Thanks for joining us. Julia Ann Smith West as well. Thanks a lot for stopping on by. Good morning to everybody checking in. A lot of people this morning getting up and going so far. If you've got weather reports out there, like from the West Memphis Airport, give us an idea of what the temperature is, sky conditions. If you got any rain this weekend, let us know what it's like, and drop your city and state location in there. We'd love to know where you're checking in around the Mid-South or from outside the Mid-South. Thanks a lot for joining us. If you've never tuned in here before, we are broadcasting, netcasting live from Memphis, Tennessee, in the southwestern corner of Tennessee. So western Tennessee, eastern Arkansas, northern about quarter of Mississippi is where we cover for our broadcast signal out there. Fog so far this morning, worst is back around Corinth, Mississippi, the Tennessee River Valley picking up some more fog more than anything else just past the top of the hour on Monday. We do have another storm system on the way. It's going to be dropping down from the northern plain states, and as it does, it's going to be giving us again the possibility of more showers and thunderstorms, none of which are showing up at this time on Storm Tracker 3S radar. So we look again at some pretty quiet conditions across much of the area. Cora Jones, where's fall? About 41 days away. That's, again, we'll talk more about the how long we've got coming up here in just a little bit, so stay tuned for that. Cindy Kins, keep your curtains closed to keep your animals cool. Actually, that's a very good idea to help your utility bill as well. If you haven't thought about that, get rid of the direct sunlight coming into your house and you'll drop the temperatures and you'll also help to save some money on that utility bill. So you don't need that pure sunshine in there opening the slats of your blinds so that the light comes in, but the direct sunlight does not. That could really help you save money out there. So please keep that in mind if you're out and about trying to drop your utility bills in this air conditioning filled summer. Heat advisory for much of West Tennessee and northern Mississippi. Again, these counties shaded in orange will be looking for heat index temperatures around 105 degrees. Now, again, that's pretty typical for this time of the year where we pick that up. But in the counties shaded in red, an excessive heat warning has been issued by the National Weather Service. And some people out there this morning already on social media have been saying, well, okay, big whoop, what is it about heat? It's going to be hot, it's August, so what? This is issued, again, for people out there to know that it's going to be hotter than normal and dangerously so. So if you're going to be working or exercising outdoors, you know to plan ahead as to what might happen. And in these counties, including Shelby County and Memphis, the heat index temperature will go well over what it is in the heat advisory counties. In this area, we could see heat index temperatures of 110 degrees plus. Some areas localized at times might hit around 115 degrees. Now, when you're out there with that thick amount of humidity, your body cools itself by evaporation. The sweat gets on and out of your skin through the inside of your body, which is why it's important to stay hydrated. And as it evaporates, it takes that heat with you. Now, in a dry condition like here in the studios where it's about 74 degrees, the air conditioning's on, the humidity is very low, the sweat just leaps right off your skin. It's not a problem. But if you are out and about today, all that humidity in the atmosphere does a very good job of impeding that evaporation. So it makes it harder to sweat and therefore harder to cool down. That's why these things are issued, to let you know what's going on out there. A lot of people, again, not feeling the love about keeping up to date on stuff like that or why it seems to be important to the National Weather Service. And to those of you out there who are saying the heat index is made up just for ratings purposes, it is a real thing. It's an actual equation. Go look it up and you'll find some very interesting ideas. Okay, so take a look at that when you have the opportunity to do so. Temperatures back into the lower to mid 80s, rising as we get into and around the area of the Mid-South with the sunshine coming on down. Rick and Angie Massengill will today be our highest temperatures. It's possible. I believe we've hit 94 or 95 a few weeks ago when we had that one hot spell. I don't think we've got anywhere close to the century mark, excuse me, over the last few weeks, so it is possible at this point in time. Cora Jones, when is the first snow due? That's some very positive forward thinking questions right there, because as of right now, the first frost on average doesn't occur in Memphis until about Veterans Day. So that gives you an idea as to what we may be seeing into and around the area there. Sandy Chavez, hope I'm saying that right, Las Vegas. Heat, it's a dry heat out there and zero humidity. That is the place where the sweat will just leap right off of you with that very low single digit humidity percentage out there. That right there can also fool you into thinking that you're doing better than you are. It'll dehydrate you faster because you don't feel all that hot because you get cooled down by that sweat out there for right now into and around the area. Helen Williamson, yes, again, the pets. Got them outside, make certain they have adequate shelter, adequate water, or just bring them indoors if you're able to do so there. All right, running the numbers into today, where you see the green, there's going to be that possibility of some showers and thunderstorms across portions of the area. It's not going to be a complete and total washout for showers and thunderstorms, but there are going to be that potential for activity out there throughout the course of the rest of the day. So if you have outdoor plans, going shopping, golf game, running errands, whatever, may want to take that umbrella with you just to be on the safe side out there. Now, through the early part of the afternoon, again, temperatures in the metro area hitting the mid-90s and staying there. These are just the air temperatures. So you combine the humidity with those, that's where you get the heat index. This is just how hot it's going to be on just the regular measurable air temperature, mid to upper 90s across a good portion of the area. Spotty showers and thunderstorms again, not that much left of them by News Channel 3 at 10. Also around midnight, still back in the lower to mid 80s. And going into tomorrow morning, some of the computer models starting to show a possibility of some more showers developing in advance of our next system coming on through. Low temperatures tomorrow, about like today, lower to mid 70s, and that's about as good as it gets by about this time tomorrow, easily back into the mid 80s. So both the heat advisory and the excessive heat warning will continue into Tuesday. So hot conditions expected there as well. Severe weather threat, not for us today. Again, could be that possibility of isolated, just generic thunderstorms here. But back to the north of us, north of I-70 in St. Louis, Chicago, Des Moines, back toward around Indianapolis, could see an elevated risk of severe weather, a slight risk for the area up here, not much for us today. But as that system drops south, by tomorrow, we could see a slight risk category for parts of southwest Tennessee. The best possibility of severe weather here, close to the area. Marginal threat for the rest of the Mid-South. Main threat tomorrow will be the possibility of storms containing damaging winds. We'll be keeping you updated on this as we go throughout the rest of the day and this evening. And don't forget to tune in to Daybreak Tuesday for more information on that. For the rest of the day today, temperatures back in the mid to upper 90s, and could be some possibilities of thunderstorms throughout the rest of the day today. Also, again, looking at the potential for heat index numbers to go well over 105 degrees, so please keep that in mind. Tomorrow, temperatures about identical. Should be looking at better chances of showers and thunderstorms developing into the afternoon and evening hours as that front gets a little bit closer to us. Wednesday, best possibility of thunderstorms will be developing overnight, continuing through about daybreak on Wednesday morning. So school bus stop, might need an umbrella early Wednesday morning, and there could still be some lightning around the area. After that, partly cloudy skies will be expected throughout the rest of midweek. And through the rest of the week, temperatures stay in the mid to upper 80s, starting to sneak back into the 90s by the weekend. So far, it does not look like any chance of rainfall after that, unless something new develops out there. Now, by Sunday and into Monday, back in the lower to mid 90s once again. So we may see that potential, maybe, of a new heat advisory going up from the National Weather Service. We don't have any indication of that right now because this is still too far in the future. So for right now, hotter, yes, by the end of next weekend, but it looks like it's going to be just regular heat, not complete and total all-consuming heat like we're seeing today with those excessive heat warnings out there. So as we go throughout the next few days and the weekend, keep it tuned to News Channel 3 for updates on that. Quick check of the tropics. Again, we're looking at numbers back pretty quiet for right now. The Gulf, the Caribbean, the Western Atlantic, very little going on at this time. And you can thank the Sahara Desert off of Africa as dry, dusty air makes its way over the Atlantic. That does a very good job of squashing anything in the way of hurricane development. So even though there might be an impulse of energy that could become a hurricane, the dry air, very gritty, very sandy air, that's not good for hurricane development. And the National Hurricane Center, because of all that, is not seeing anything in the way of development over the next 2 to 5 days. So looking pretty quiet toward the weekend. We are approaching the peak of hurricane season. So if you have plans for travel to any of these areas, please keep it tuned to News Channel 3 for the updates on that. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at weather_WREG3. Keep you updated on what's going on out there with a lot of other information as well. One more check of the forecast. And again, looking at numbers back into the mid-90s at least by lunchtime, upper 90s briefly for highs this afternoon, and that chance of isolated showers and thunderstorms may pop up at just about any point in time throughout the rest of the day. So if you have outdoor plans, be aware of that. Remember, when thunder roars, go indoors. If you have marching band practice, if you have football practice after school, if anybody out there sees lightning, here's the thunder. You are within range of getting struck, so safety first, safety always, and especially with that heat out there, make certain you're paying attention to what's going on with everybody's temperature and make certain to avoid the possibility of anything involving heat injuries. If you'd like to see more about what heat injuries are and how you can prevent them, go to wreg.com/weather where you can get this forecast and you can get more details from the Center for Disease Control from the United States government about what to look for and first aid as you go through the day today to keep an eye on what is out there. If you'd like to see more about what time is left in the seasons, head to a little bit farther down our page here, and you can see the countdown clock to autumn. Do you want to keep the weather around? Do you like to keep the summer around because you love the hot temperatures? Or are you ready for fall to be here? Cast your vote and let us know what you think. Again, at facebook.com/WREG3. That'll wrap it up for this edition of our early edition of Weather Overtime. Live from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Stay tuned for more on your forecast updates throughout the rest of the day. I'll be back with Daybreak tomorrow, and Tim and Jim will have more on your forecast coming up later today on News Channel 3, First at 4. Thanks for joining us today, and make certain everybody stays safe out there, especially where the heat is concerned, and we'll have updates on your forecast coming up later on tonight. Thanks for joining us.